वक्रतुंड महाकाय निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। ककारं भररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनीं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। विवसंपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरो वन्दे परमेश्वरो। So now we are doing this samasa, we are going to do following the text entoined part 2. In this text so many rules will be given and they are based on sutras. Wherever possible I will quote the sutras, but every time I may not explain the sutras because explanation of sutras require further sutras. If one to explain one sutra I have to tell this word will have bha sangha, and because it has got bha sangha it will have lopa. Now some of you may not be knowing what is bha. We thought pa pa ba ba, that is bha we know. When in Panini there is a bha sangha is there. Have you been taught bha sangha? Okay. In this one also it is taught, bala bha sangha is not taught. And then t lopa and all that. T you have been taught, t, not 11 o'clock t, the t sangha is there. Then t lopa will happen. So therefore I have some constraints. Therefore, some places I will say this is based on the sutras. I will try to give sutra and sutra number. So those who are familiar, they can work further. And in fact, most of the rules which are given are meant for only some exceptional words which we hardly use. Many of them are like that. So my approach would be to balance both, give some sutras but not going too much into depth. So either both will be satisfied or both will be dissatisfied. So so people who want to learn by sutras only, they will be dissatisfied. And the people who say no Swamiji, sutra no, we just tell me what is final, so they also will be dissatisfied because I am giving some sutras. Or both can be satisfied because Swamiji gave sutras also. And Swamiji explained in a simple manner. So it depends upon my prarabdha, your prarabdha, whether both are satisfied or both are dissatisfied. I'll be doing like a karma yoga attitude, you know. So karmanyevadhikaraste. Okay. Now we will be doing from the 20th lesson. The topic is compounds, samasaha. Yeah, in fact, they should have written samasaha. Compounds, no? All right. And in the first two paragraphs, what he has written is explanation of one Paniniya Sutra, which is, I will write, the sutra is this samarthaha padavidhi. It is 211. You have got the sutra book? Please see, 211 is there. Samarthaha Padavidhi. So for a change, you know, otherwise generally I don't allow the book. You brought the book? You don't have?
I have, but
it's a message. Oh, okay, no problem. Is there this sutra, is there? Samarthaha Padavidhi. Okay. So, now I will explain what is the sutra. In this, two words are there, Samarthaha Padavidhi. Samarthaha, which case it is? Now please be here, okay? Please close the book, sutra book close, yeah. Or put it inside. So when I start talking, you please close the book, okay? Because both cannot be open. Samarthaha Padavidhi. Samarthaha, which case? Prathama, one. Okay? Prathama Vibhakti, Ekvachanam. Padavidhi, Prathama Vibhakti, Ekvachanam. In fact, that is the style of explaining sutras. I think you must have been taught. First, Vibhakti. Now, Padavidhi is Padasya Vidhi. And vidhi means karyam, vidhiyate iti vidhi. I am going a little bit deeper, but I hope that this much is okay. I didn't want to go this far, but somehow when we go there, we feel like. So vidhiyate iti vidhi karyam. So vidhi means karyam. Karyam here does not mean product. Karyam means operation. Grammatical operation is called karyam. So vidhi means grammatical operation. Grammatical operation means like samasa, taddita, all these are operations. So, vidhiyate iti vidhihi karyam. Karyam means grammatical operation. Padasya means related to pada. So, padasya vidhihi means grammatical operation related to the words. Padavidhihi means grammatical operation related to the words. So there are some operations which we talked about in Paniniya Vyakaranam. Those operations which are related to pada, not varna, pada, they are called padavidhihi. Is padavidhi idea is clear? Operations like samasa, taddita, all are these padavidhi. Whatever operation related to pada, they are called padavidhihi. And padavidhihi samarthaha. Yes, samartha has got the meaning samarthashritaha. Lakshanaya samartha means samarthashritaha. Operation related to words is done only on competent. Samarthashritaha. Operation related to the words is done on those words which are competent. You remember simple one. Any surgery, operation is surgery also is called operation, no? So operation is done on whom? Who is fit for operation? You know, many times doctors say operation is required, but operation cannot be done on this person. After certain age, certain operations, even though required, not done. So it's a simple principle. Operation related to words is done only to those words which are capable, competent. Competent for what? Competent to go through this padavidhi. Is meaning clear? Samarthaha padavidhi. So final meaning will be what? Grammatical operation will be done on those words which are competent. Is it clear? Samarthaha padavidhi. Idea clear? Surgery will be done on the person who is fit for surgery. Similarly, grammatical operation by the Dr. Panini will be done on which words? The words which are competent. All right. Now, this samartha or samarthashrita means competent. Competent means what? One who has got competence, capacity. Who is capable? Who has got capacity is called capable. Capability one who has is called capable. Similarly, who is samartha? Samartha. The samartha is one who has got samarthyam. The one who has got capacity is capable. So now question comes, what type of samarthyam the word should have, because of which they will become competent, fit for operation? Like for surgery, what type of capacity is required? His BP should be normal, sugar should be brought normal, his hemoglobin should be okay. All these things are called the fitness for operation. So similarly, these words to go for operation, what type of capacity is required? In that context, there are two types of capacity talked about in grammar. So samartha means capable. Capable means having capacity. Now, what are the types of capacity? That is the next topic. For that, there is no sutra, okay? But it is talked about by the commentators. All this I have to talk about because this Antoine first two paragraphs are talking about this. It's not that just like that I'm telling. It is there. But he talks in an English manner. So we are trying to learn in a Paniniya style. Okay. Now, two types of samarthyam. Capacity. Two types of capacity which make the words capable. One is called Vyapeksha. Vyapeksha Lakshana Samarthyam. Second is Ekarthi Bhava. So first is called Vyapeksha Lakshana Samarthyam. Capacity in the form of Vyapeksha. And others is capacity in the form of Ekarthi Bhava. So two types of strength are there. Vyapeksha and Ekarthi Bhava. Oh, I have to be careful. Other samartha, samarthi will go away. Vyapeksha and Ekarthi Bhava. So these are the two types of strength which make words capable of certain types of operation. It is not that if one has got one, the word will be capable for all operations. If Vyapeksha is there, one type of operation, semantic operation, will be possible. It's called semantic. Semantic means related to the meaning of the language. It's called semantic. Some people may not be knowing. Cementing means we all think of cement only. That's not cement, that building cement, not that. Okay? So Vyapeksha is one type of capacity. Ekarthi Bhava is another type of capacity. So these are the names of capacity. Capacity of whom? Words. Okay. So Vyapeksha and Ekarthi Bhava. Now let us understand what is Vyapeksha. Vyapeksha means words have got capacity to be related to the other word. Like he gives the example, Rajnah Purushah. Rajnah is, what is the identification of Rajnah? Can anybody do? Of? Nakaranta? Tu said napumsakli. Okay, nakaranta. एक षष्ठी यस सो राजना हाँ यस राजन शब्द षष्ठी विभक्ति एकवचन राजना हाँ मीन्स व्हाट ऑफ द किंग पुरुषा मीन्स ए पर्सन हियर पर्सन इज इन द सेंस ऑफ सर्वेंट In Indian languages, we use this. Ye mera aadmi hai, you know. Means, he is my person or ye uska aadmi hai. So, it has got the idea of a servant, attendant, assistant. So, in that sense, it is person. So, the word Rajnaha has got capacity to be related to Purusha, of the king. When it is said of the king, there is akanksha. When we say of the king, you will have a question. Of the king what? Of the king palace, building, city, person, what? So Rajnaha word has got akanksha, expectancy. And also it has got yogyata, fitness. And similarly this word Purusha, person, servant, also has got akanksha. Person or a servant of what? And therefore, because of or on account of or based on expectancy, yogyata, fitness, this Rajnaha and Purusha, these two words have got mutual grammatical relationship. Rajnaha, Purushaha, we can say, Devadattaha Rajnaha Purushaha Bhavati. So these two words can be combined semantically with each other. Meaning wise they can be connected. That capacity of the words to be mutually related is called vyapeksha. The capacity of the words to be related to the other words is called vyapeksha. And that is the case in the vakya, in a sentence, where words are not combined. Asamasta padam. This vyapeksha we are talking with regard to the words which are not compounded. Rajnaha Purushaha. Rajnaha word has got the capacity to be combined with Purusha. Purusha word has got capacity to be combined with Rajnaha. This capacity in terms of having mutual relationship, that is called Vyapeksha. And that is based on Vyapeksha is the strength of the words to be connected to the other words based on three things. Akanksha, expectancy. I will write Akanksha. This is a little bit too deep I am going, but it will be useful to know. Akanksha, Yogyata, and Asatti. Three things, akanksha, yogyata, asatti. Akanksha means expectancy. They have got the expectancy. Like Ramaha Gachati. So it has got the expectancy where? So Gramam. So Ramaha can be connected with Gramam. That is why they have got Vyapeksha. So first thing is Akanksha. Akanksha means expectancy. Yogyata means they can be combined. There will not be any logical problem. You will understand yogyata when yogyata is not there, you understand. Like we say, vandhina sinchati. Vandhina sinchati. Saha. Okay, just to make the sentence complete. Saha, that person sprinkling the trees or watering the trees, sinchati means watering, sprinkling, how? Fire, with fire. Means he's sprinkling fire. So, this vannina and sinchati, they do not have yogyata. Why? Because with fire, sprinkling cannot be done. With fire, sprinkling cannot be done. Fire cannot be used with sinchati, and sinchati does not have yogyata to be fitted with, to gel with vannina. So this is the case of what? Ayogyata. Means they don't have, they cannot go. Even though grammatically nothing wrong. Sentence grammatically is correct. Saha karta vannina karana. Sinchati kriyapada. Grammatically, there is no problem. But logically, it will not go. So that type of logical contradiction should not be there. Like somebody says, Aham akasham khadami. So yogyata is there? Not there. You understand now what is yogyata required? Because generally yogyata is there. We read the sentences with yogyata only. Therefore, we want to understand what is yogyata, not there. Yogyata means this logical contradiction should not be there. Akasham khadami. Yogyata is not there. So, second is what? Yogyata should be there. The two words to be combined, akanksha should be there, yogyata should be there. And third one is asatti. Proximity. Asatya means proximity. Means what? I use the word Devadattaha, Rajnaha, and then kept quiet for 1 hour, 2 hours. And all of a sudden say, Purushaha Bhavati. Then they will not have connection. The capacity to be connected will not be there if they are pronounced after a very long time, long gap. Therefore, they should have this also. You imagine, One word I tell in the morning, and then evening one word I tell, then they will not have capacity to be connected. So asatya means proximity. So they should have enough proximity so that this word is written in our mind. Perhaps you can take 1 minute. Ragnaha. Then you Purushaha. Perhaps okay. Because you are expecting me to take some pause. But if it is not there, then it should be said Ragnaha Purushaha Bhavati. So you understood these are the three factors. Akanksha, Yogyata, Asatti. Based on that, the words will have capacity to be connected to each other. And that capacity of the words is called Vyapeksha Lakshana Samarthyam. Is it clear? Vyapeksha Lakshana Samarthyam? Okay. And in this type of Samarthyam, every word retains its individuality. Rajnaha Purushaha. Rajnaha has got Vyapeksha. Vyapeksha is there or not? Purusha has got Vyapeksha or not? So both have got Vyapeksha. And both will retain their individuality. And therefore, what will happen? you can qualify this word rajnaha further. You can say devadattaha veerasya rajnaha. You can further add, because rajna has got capacity to be conveyed with others, but at the same time it maintains its individuality. Unlike what? Unlike samasta padam. This point I am telling to contrast with samasa. Rajnaha, capacity to be connected, but still maintains, you know, individuality. So rajnaha purushaha. It's like a Western marriage, you know. So they maintain their individuality, not becoming like one unit. So rajnaha purushaha. So rajnaha we can write veerasya. Veerasya. So we can say veerasya rajnaha. Purusha also we can say sundaraha purushaha. Kurupaha purushaha. Ugly fellow. Also we can say whatever. So two things in Vyapeksha. One is that they have the capacity there to be related to each other, and at the same time they maintain their individuality. And this particular Vyapeksha we talk about in the context of Asamasta Padam. Is it clear? What is Asamasta Padam? What is the example? Correct. Rajnaha Purusha. So Asamasta Padam in a Vakya. So here Rajnaha Purusha has got Vyapeksha. And therefore Padavidhi in the form of the grammatical operation in the form of Anvaya can be done. So Anvaya can be done with those words which have got Vyapeksha. Okay, Anvaya we do, no? I hope you remember what is Anvaya. What we do morning, evening for shlokas, that Anvaya. That is possible. All right? Okay. So now Vyapeksha is clear, I hope so. Vyapeksha clear? Okay, now. So now I am Samartha to go for Ekarthi Bhava. Ekarthi Bhava means the status of conveying the composite meaning unitedly, collectively. The status of conveying the composite meaning unitedly, that is called Ekarthi Bhava. Bhava means status. The status or the capacity of conveying the composite meaning unitedly, collectively. There is a grammar, is a Sanskrit, there is a nice definition. Samudaya shakta, shaktya visishtekartha pratipadaka. Samudaya shaktya. This is what I said in English, I am telling in Sanskrit. Samudaya shaktya means by collective power. Vishishtekartha pratipadakata. The capacity of revealing the composite meaning. Vishishtekartha means composite meaning. This will be clear when I say samasa. Rajapurushaha. So, Raja, Rajnaha, Purusha. Rajnaha and Purusha, these two words, have got the capacity to make a compound and conveying this composite meaning. Rajnaha and Purusha, these two words have got the capacity टू फॉर्म ए कंपाउंड ए ग्रामेटिकल यूनिट एंड कन्वेइंग दिस कॉम्पोजिट मीनिंग. राजना पुरुषा विल बिकम राजपुरुषा एंड इट विल हैव द मीनिंग रॉयल सर्वेंट और ऑफिसर. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ वर्ड्स टू कंबाइन एंड कलेक्टिवली कन्वे ए कॉम्पोजिट मीनिंग दैट इज कॉल्ड एकार्थी भाव लक्षण सामर्थ्यम. इज इट क्लियर? राजा एंड पुरुष हैज गॉट दिस सामर्थ्यम ऑल्सो. दे कैन कंबाइन राजा पुरुष दे कैन कंबाइन फॉर्मिंग ए कंपाउंड एंड कन्वे ए कॉम्पोजिट मीनिंग. दैट टाइप ऑफ सामर्थ्यम ऑफ द वर्ड्स इज कॉल्ड एकार्थी भाव लक्षण सामर्थ्यम. इज इट क्लियर? एकार्थी भाव लक्षण. सो इन केस ऑफ राज्ञः पुरुषः दिस टाइप ऑफ सामर्थ्य इज देयर. बट देवदत्तः ग्रामं गच्छति. हियर देवदत्तः एंड ग्रामं दिस टू वर्ड्स हैज गॉट व्यपेक्षा और नॉट. व्यपेक्षा इज देयर, दे कैन बी कंबाइंड, बट दे डू नॉट हैव एकार्थी भावा. देवदत्ता एंड ग्रामम कैन नॉट बी कंबाइंड. दे कैन नॉट कंबाइन एंड गिव ए कॉम्पोजिट मीनिंग. वाई? बिकॉज वॉट कैन बी कंबाइन विथ वॉट इज गवर्न बाय द रूल्स. वी आर, दैट इज वॉट समास प्रकरणम इज. एवरीथिंग कैन नॉट बी कंबाइन विथ एवरीथिंग. सो देवदत्ता एंड ग्रामम दे हैव गॉट व्यपेक्षा लक्षण सामर्थ्यम बट एकार्थी भावा इज नॉट देयर. वाई? बिकॉज देवदत्ता एंड ग्रामम कैन नॉट बी कंबाइंड फॉर्मिंग ए कंपाउंड एंड कलेक्टिवली कन्वेइंग कॉम्पोजिट मीनिंग. इज इट क्लियर? सो एकार्थी भावा मीन्स द वर्ड्स हैविंग कैपेसिटी टू फॉर्म ए कंपाउंड एंड कलेक्टिवली कन्वेइंग the composite meaning, integrated meaning, like Rajapurusha conveys royal person. That is called Ekarthi Bhava. All right. And therefore, Samasa can happen only between the words which have got the second type of Samarthya. Okay? Compound can happen only between the words which have got second type of samarthyam. Is it clear? Ekarthi bhava samarthyam one who has, those words alone can have this samasa. So idea is that samartha pada vidhi does not mean that any strength we have. It should have specific strength. Ekarthi bhava strength they have, then only they can be samartha and then only padavidhi. Yes? It will be there. In fact, if vyapeksha is not there, this ekarthi bhava cannot come. In fact, that is a basic one. So the words themselves cannot come together, then how can they combine? Two people don't meet eye to eye with each other, you know, they don't look at each other, how can they embrace? So samasa is like embracing. For embracing, at least they have to talk to each other. So vyapeksha is little lower, just looking at eye of each other. So that is possible, vyapeksha. But they cannot embrace. Whereas samasa means embracing, therefore vyapeksha will definitely be there. Is it clear? Vyapeksha has to be there for this Ekarthi Bhava to be there. Is it clear? Not clear? Means if Vyapeksha itself is not there, they cannot be connected. You know, grammatically they cannot be connected. Where is the question of Ekarthi Bhava? Not possible. Ekarthi Bhava means what? They should be combined. They should have grammatical ability to be combined. And then conveying the composite meaning. So that is, this is a higher strength. You know. First you have high by relationship, then only you will have close relationship. High by itself is not possible. Then where is the question of close relationship? Ekarthi Bhava indicates the strength in the form of close relationship. Is it clear? Okay. And therefore, this is the Ekarthi Bhava Lakshana. But all words will not have. Only some words will have the ability to come together and convey composite meaning. Which words have got the capacity to come together and convey composite meaning is governed by, guided by Panini sutras. Is it clear? Therefore, we have got so many sutras. Panchami, Saptami, Shaundehi, all this, you know. Any word cannot be combined. What can be combined is discovered by Panini. All right, is it clear? Okay. Now let us read this, our dear Antoine. So now it will be clear. The various case endings indicate the various relationship that exists between the words of a sentence. Is this clear? Case endings means what we call vibhakti pratyaya. They indicate what? Relationship. Kartra, karta, karma, karana. All vibhakti pratyaya are indicating what? Relationship. That exists between the words of a sentence. Like what? Ramaha gramam gachati. So Ramaha, case ending is what? Su. Su. And gramam, am. So they are case endings. And that indicates what? The relationship of kartru karma. Is it clear? That's what is said here. Those mutual relationship are called vyapeksha by the Sanskrit grammarians. Now is it clear? That relationship or rather the capacity of being related is called vyapeksha by Sanskrit grammarians. He is not a Sanskrit grammarian. He said some people are telling. Okay. Every word having its case ending, besides being related to other words in the sentence, retains its individuality. You remember I had told this. Okay. And can be further qualified or determined by other words. This also I had explained. Ragnaha, virasya ragnaha. Okay. When I say viraha shatruna hataha. Viraha means a hero, hataha, killed by enemy. I am free to specify further the character of the hero and the enemy. So we can say tarunaha viraha nrusamsena shatruna hataha. Means what? The young hero was killed by the cruel enemy. Is this idea clear? What we have understood? Huh? All right. Now second. The Sanskrit language is characterized by its capacity to combine two or more words. It should be T-W. It should be two. T-W. Combine two or more words standing in mutual grammatical relations into one single word. This we have already seen. The Sanskrit has got this capacity that two or more words can be combined. Who are standing in mutual grammatical relationship? They should have first vyapeksha, then only they can be connected. And also they should have ekarthi bhava. The words thus combined or thrown together form what is called samasa or combined. Why he says thrown together? Because sam as dhatu is there. As means to throw. Therefore he says, they combine or thrown together. So really Ragnaha Purusha are thrown together. Like you throw something in and make something out of it. In fact, they use the word. You throw some chili and throw some carrot. And they use like this. Then this dish will come. They use the word throw. I don't like, but that's what they say. To make some item, they say you throw something. Yeah. So here the words are thrown. And samasa will be formed. So I hope you understood this sentence. Is it clear? Okay. They can no longer be treated separately. Means now Ragnaha Purusha connected Raja Purusha, then they are not treated separately. They form an indivisible whole. Now they are treated as one entity, like married couple. Now they have got, even law also, they have got one, they can file together as one unit. So, indivisible whole. Their grammatical unity is called Ekarthi Bhava. That Ekarthi Bhava means their unity. Means their being one, capable of conveying the meaning. That he is using the word grammatical unity. Grammatical unity means being one, having the capacity to convey the composite meaning. That is called grammatical unity. He is called Ekarthi Bhavaha. All right, that's why I told you he will tell in an English manner. We have understood in Paninian manner. Okay. If instead of Shatruna Hataha, I write Shatru Hataha in one word, I am no longer able to qualify the word Shatru by a separate adjective. Once I make a samasa, then I cannot say that Veera Shatru or Taruna Veera or Drusamsa. Drusamsa means cruel. So I cannot now qualify Shatru or Veera. Shatru I cannot qualify. Veera I can qualify. Shatru Hataha. I am no longer to qualify the word Shatru by a separate adjective, Shatru Hataha. I cannot now qualify. Shatru Hataha is now referring to the Viraha. So only it will be qualifying Viraha. And now further Vira you can qualify. For Shatru, four means because Shatru has become an indivisible whole qualifying the word Viraha. So now it has become one composite unit and therefore you cannot qualify by separate words to the first member of the samasa. All right. So here, this is the idea conveyed by these two paragraphs. I hope these two paragraphs are clear. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the next class. All right. Now, in the next class, we will see some more details given by this text. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.